Hello again, this is Kent from simpletutorials.net. I'm hoping you're having a great day, and we are going to be doing an animation today in Inkscape. It'll just have four frames. It'll be a stop animation, a very simple animation, but I just wanted to show you what you can do with a certain extension called Sozi, and I'll get a little more into this maybe eventually. I saw it just recently used once in openclipart.org. This is a drawing, or some art I found at openclipart.org, and we are starting out with this, and we're going to duplicate this and the frame. The frame's going to be, it's going to help us with our animation. I'll just do a bunch of duplications. Well, I should say maybe three, I guess. And then another one. I'm moving it over, holding my control key down, and then letting go of my mouse. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're just going to have this pumpkin slowly open one of his eyelids. So, it's just going to make it a lot easier. You can do whatever you want with your, hopefully this will prompt you to do your own animation. Okay. That's good enough. Okay, so I am going to make an animation out of this right now. And these frames are important. They won't be seen in the animation. And this is when you're looking at an SVG file in a browser. But we have to use them. And I'll just have frame 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then we're going to go up to extensions, and if you're with your Inkscape, you probably don't have Sozi unless you installed it yourself. I suggest you go to one of your whatever search engine you use. And if it's Google, just type in Sozi, and the link should come up to the top where you can go in and figure out how to install it. It looks simple from the instructions, but if you go out of order, it might not work. I had to remove everything and then start from scratch and installing Inkscape and then so on as the instructions say. So what we did is we clicked on this frame, we opened up Sozi in the extensions, and then we're going to hit this plus to create a new frame. I'm just going to call this 1 because that'll be frame 1. And then I will leave it clipped. I'll tell you eventually what that is. I'm going to enable the timeout. This is going to allow it to move from slide to slide by itself without me moving it with the right arrow key or my left mouse button. You can also use the space bar, but I will put in 0.5, and then I'll make sure my transition time is a little more than 0.5, 0.6. And then I'll use the same zoom, at least on this one, and then I'll do immediate. And then we'll go ahead and do this again. Now each time you have to open up Sozi. It'd be nice if you could just leave it open, but when you start out, you have to close it every time when you're creating the slides or the frames. Do this again. 0.5, or I could do 0.4. 4, and then just as long as the transition time of the frame is longer than this timeout. And I'll go down here and go to immediate beginning. Now if you have it the other way around, then it won't be automated and you'll operate it using your keyboard or your mouse, left button on your mouse. And we'll go down here and do slide 3, and then we'll do a 0.4, 0.5, This just makes it appear immediately. And then we'll have the last slide. Four. And we'll do 0.4 and 0.5. And then immediate again. Okay, everything looks good. Okay, and then we'll save this. And see. And I'll do pumpkin and animate. And then what we want to do is we want to go to your file that you just created. And I'll open it with Opera browser. Sometimes some browsers won't work correctly with these SVG files. Okay, so as you notice, I did something wrong. It stopped on frame 3. We'll go back to the beginning. See? So it automated. Basically what I did was, hit enable for the automatic slides. So if we look at this, slide 1 is enabled, slide 2 enabled, 3 is disabled, so we have to hit that, and let's go to the last one. That's needs to be enabled also. If you go back here, it's okay. So anyway, let's save it and then go back to our and then we go refresh. It's pretty simple animation, but it shows you what can be done with stop animation inside Inkscape. And then you can actually do record the screen and make your own animation from this, or you know, like a video. So I hope you enjoyed that. This is Kent again from simpletutorials.net. I hope you're having a great day, and hope it gets better if it's not good so far. Thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye.